are happy to welcome back to the show Dr. Steve Margiotis. He's here now to discuss a different type of relationship. Good to have you here.
Very nice to be back.
We're going to be talking about a codependent relationship.
Yes.
Define that.
Codependent is an interaction between two people. Okay, but there's a difference between it being a positive interaction and a negative interaction.
Well, aren't all relationships codependent
then? Absolutely. But the difference is if it's between an interaction that's positive between two people, then you have that synergy that results in a positive result. When it's negative, it's based more on control. It's based more on jealousy. When it's positive, it's based more on love and trust.
Ironic that we talk about codependency on Independence Day.
Absolutely.
But when you're in a codependent relationship, and we're going to talk about the negative here and, you know, how to help people or spot the signs of it, are we talking husband, wife, brother, sister, mother, child? What are we really focusing on here?
We're focusing on all those interactions.
All of those.
Okay, it could be employees. Okay, it
employees.
Could be employees.
Really?
Yes. The difference is, it's about a dynamic when it's negative. That's one person's taking and one person's giving. And it's one dimensional all the time. If it doesn't feel good, it probably isn't good for you.
Okay, all right. So what are some of the underlying issues that can contribute to this becoming an issue?
I think what happened is that when you grow up, you grew up in a house that wasn't very nurturing. So now what you're trying to do is replay that by nurture, by caring for somebody else. You're good at it. So what you're doing is you're caring for somebody and you're feeling good by caring for that person, but the truth is inside, you're really feeling empty.
Well, can it be the reverse though? You're saying that it's usually somebody going out trying to help somebody.
Right.
Are those out there who prey on the
yes.
vulnerable then?
And those people just take and take and take and they don't give back. So one person's doing all the taking, one person's giving all the giving, and it's really empty on both sides. One person doesn't know how to nurture back. It's not a give and take. It doesn't result in synergy. And it leaves an emptiness that leaves you as empty as you were as a kid.
And dysfunctional. So what type of warning signs do we need to look for if we are in a codependent relationship or might know somebody who's in this?
I think the key thing is education, and then I think the key thing is to trust your feelings. Okay, when you're in it, when you're interacting with that person, you're distracted from your own needs. But after the fact, 2 hours later, when you're not interacting with that person, it doesn't feel good because you're not getting anything back. And I'm talking about the person that's giving. The person that's taking, their need is to control the whole dynamic, okay? And what they get out of that control is to help them, because when they were growing up, they couldn't control the environment.
Well, what's wrong with
go ahead.
What's wrong with giving?
Nothing at all, as long as you get something back. It doesn't have to be 50-50, but there needs to be this balance back and forth. But if it's 90-10 and all you're doing is giving and getting nothing back, and you know when you're in an interaction with that, and if the other person's only taking and taking and taking, you know there's something wrong with that. And I'm talking about from the getting a gift, getting a compliment, you know, I'm giving more than I'm getting back.
Yeah, this isn't just, you're not talking, it's emotional as well as materialistic.
Absolutely.
Is what you're saying. All right, so again, at what line does this cross over into abuse?
It crosses over to abuse when it gets even more hostile and gets more negative and gets physical, okay? When you're being...
Let's, you know, break it down into what types of relationship are we talking about? Husband, wife in a bad relationship, mother, child, maybe somebody's dealing with an aging parent and they, you know, they give and parents taking or vice versa even.
I think it could be any of those interactions, and I think the end result is if you're giving and you're not getting compliments back and acknowledgement for what you're doing, but you're getting judged all the time, and it becomes a very punitive and hostile relationship. The biggest mistake is trying to continue to please. No matter how much you give, you're not getting anything back. There's an emptiness inside that cannot be fulfilled by just giving and not getting anything back.
It almost sounds like an addiction, and those cycles are very difficult to break.
Absolutely.
First, I guess, two-pronged question. Is it like an addiction?
It's an addiction because you're addicted to not so much the person, but that interaction. So you can find a lot of different people to be codependent with. You're addicted to the interaction. It's like being on a treadmill. You're really not doing anything. So it's the interaction more than the individual. You're looking for people that replicate that dynamic you had growing up over and over and over.
All right, so final thoughts on how to break this cycle, get into a healthy relationship.
Education, read books, go to similar to Alcoholics Anonymous, they have codependent anonymous groups. You have to break that cycle and you have to trust your feelings. If it doesn't feel good, the truth of the matter is this interaction is not healthy for you.
So go get help.
Go get help.
Read up. All right,
absolutely.
Dr. Steve Margiotis, we thank you so much and look forward to having you back again.
Thank you. Nice to be here.
All right.